COVID-19 pandemic has created a new kind of daily life that will not and cannot go back to the life before the pandemic. The concept of non-contact, which suddenly came knocking to our lives, has now become a normal part of our everyday life at work, at school, and life in general. Now, meeting and trying to connect online has become a new stream of culture. Attending classes, holding meetings, and enjoying performances online are some of the things we have become used to. In this era, when offline contact has been cut off, online tools satisfy human beings' need for connection and communication, building a new set of trends and culture. Such social changes are powerful enough to be heralded as a paradigm shift, the new normal. This era has even changed the paradigm of communication. Then how are Catholic communication tools being used? With the terrifying spread of COVID-19, church doors were closed, and even when they reopened, communities were still not able to gather together to celebrate Mass during the past year. Churches in different parts of the world attempted to communicate with the people through different methods. Mobilizing phones, text messages, and social networking platforms, they searched out new ways to communicate and interact for pastoral activities. Broadcasting Mass and holding Mass through YouTube was a must, and diverse religious contents were produced. Keeping pace with such trends, communicators, including media and publishers of different countries, are still continuing to challenge themselves to provide new platforms to maintain and enrich our religious lives. Due to COVID-19, online pastoral activities and developing Catholic contents have become more important than ever before. Since they are the communication tools that realize and share the Christian faith, it is now vital to go beyond quantitative growth and pursue qualitative growth. What more do we have to do to go further from seeing online communication only as a tool and technology to doing more with them? In 2021, in a discourse released ahead of the 55th World Communications Day, Pope Francis pointed out the opportunities and potential risks of online tools and stressed the importance of true communication methods. In his discourse, the Pope declared, "We are responsible for our communication, for the information we share, and for disclosing and controlling fake news." He stated that we were called to become witnesses of the truth and that we must go forth to observe and share. One aspect demonstrating that the world is connected by communication tools is the situation in Myanmar, where people are suffering from the military coup. Writings, photos, and videos that people have posted on social media are playing the most effective role in informing the international community about the current situations in Myanmar. By participating in campaigns where churches and people from different nations post photos on social media, the communication networks are becoming channels for sharing their pain. Likewise, in this age of COVID pandemic, the communication tools connecting us together is becoming an area whose role and importance is ever increasing. What efforts have the global communicators been making in overcoming the pandemic crisis? Are we truly connected? Let us search for the vision that will open an era where online connection is just normal, not a new normal.